It's been a long-lasting debate. Can and will iPad, or iPad Pro to be exact, be able to fully replace your laptop or desktop? While opinions were different, reviewers and experts agreed on one thing. Hardware is there, but the software? Not really. With the release of latest iPad Pro, powered by Apple's in-house M1 processor, identical to the one that powers latest Macs, the story may have changed. Hello friends and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, rumors and opinions. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment, hit the like button and don't forget to enable all notifications so you don't miss the next video. If you ever wanted a good website, a blog, a social network, a web store and everything with elite class hosting, look no further than my buddies from Ireland, Blackbeard Hosting. Simple, easy to use website installer, 24/7 customer support, real people and more, hosted on fast, reliable and secure servers. Hey, even VPN is included. Check it out, 1 month free trial, no credit card needed. The link is in the description and in the comment. With Digital Marketing's code, you get 5% off. Blackbeard Hosting. Hosting as it should be. Apple's April event has caught us off guard, even if we got clues from Mark Gurman about iPad Pro and new iMac potentially powered by the same silicon. Processing potential and amount of system memory has never been similar between these two kinds of devices. With iPad Pro finally getting option between 8 and 16 gigs of memory, iPad has received huge power boost. While we came to the point that both can be considered as daily drivers and desktop replacers, iPad is still more versatile. If you need a machine to carry, it's way more practical, especially 11-inch model, due to its size. Now, with Apple's magic keyboard, not that much. One thing that truly changed meanwhile is battery. The moment Apple launched MacBooks with M1 silicon, these laptops achieve whole new level of battery life that now beats the iPad Pro to the punch. iPad Pro's huge improvements would be even more obvious if MacBook Pro and MacBook Air weren't so power efficient. Frankly, with identical internals, it seems harder to make the choice between these two form factors. At one end, we have one complete, more modern hardware and visual style, while other for now still holds an edge on software. While some may not agree with me, I truly believe that iPad problem was not that much software as the way how users simply have used to interact with their computers, at least what we consider as computers, desktop and laptops. Yes, there is a software factor, and in many scenarios, it depends from third-party developers. Honestly, there is so much that you can accomplish with iPad device already. Text editor, full-blown presentations, web browsers, movie players and apps, split windows, copy, paste, drag and drop functionality. If you want to print the document, you can do it if your printer supports wireless connection via AirPrint. USB-C Thunderbolt allows you to connect external devices such as hard drives, cameras, microphones, monitors. If you're in video and photo editing, vector graphics and art overall, you can find awesome alternatives which may lack some features of their robust macOS counterparts, but they're still perfectly capable, since many developers have been already on the M1 train, making their apps compatible with Apple chip. There is a chance that identical software easily finds its spot at iPad Pro selection list. As far as multitasking concerns go, which is not as good and practical as the one on macOS or Windows, God forbid, it's better than it was, and we will see more improvements, but we need to stop thinking the way we got used to. Anyone who begins their computer journey with the iPad as their primary machine will be very comfortable with it later, and it will even have a hard time to use anything else. When I speak with Android users, for example, they find iOS more complicated. Even if iOS can be considered as a really simple operating system, it's not uncommon to hear an opinion, if you're uncertain, should you buy a MacBook or iPad Pro, the purchase of iPad does not make sense from financial standpoint. But if you go beyond people's habits and their specific demands, you will see that's not entirely accurate. 11-inch iPad Pro with better display, powered by fully unlocked M1 with 8 gigs of system memory, with previous generation Magic Keyboard or Smart Keyboard Folio, cost as much or less as base MacBook Air, which comes with one graphic core less. Yes, MacBook does bring 13-inch display and more base storage, but how many average users will be utilizing so much space depends from individual needs. By the way, you can spice up your iPad Pro with more storage options for a price jump. Choosing 12.9-inch iPad Pro model is $300 more expensive than 11-inch variant, but it comes down with the best display in the industry, even better than the one on MacBook Pro. To be honest, for students and everyday users, just a regular iPad can provide enough, unless there is an urge for an application that is not available for iPadOS. In other words, anyone who will not be tied to a specific platform will be more than happy with the iPad. There are cases when considering iPad Pro or any other iPad model simply does not make sense. Some fully fledged apps for professionals, apps for developers, and similar. As mentioned previously, Apple did choose the M1 for iPad Pro for a reason. How quickly will software varieties become available for Apple Silicon within the iPad is likely a matter of time. That's why this year's WWDC may be the most important event for the iPad's future. Sadly, some variants may never be suitable for ARM-based chips. But then 3DS Max doesn't work on Intel-based MacBook neither. So if you're not certain which path you should choose, base it purely on the apps and features of those apps that you use and need. MacBook is nothing new, and until we get new iterations with mini LED and new chips, it's not even the right time to compare it with the latest iPad Pro monster from Cupertino. The iPad Pro is way more superior device that offers a lot for the money. With the M1, it's a powerful beast that can be unleashed if and when Apple and third-party developers truly introduce fully-fledged professional-grade software specifically designed for it. While you will have to deal with dongles due to its limited number of ports, slightly rigid multitasking and lack of app support for time being, you will have probably the best display in the industry, device with double form factor, good camera, AR capabilities, 5G, etc. The existing MacBook lineups don't offer anything new, fresh, or exciting. It's contrary. They're even getting rid of it in order to make iPad Pro rise. Beside the best overall laptop OS in the world and familiar premium design, current MacBooks, for now, is just an old news. I'm a big fan of iPad Pro. I find calling Apple to bring macOS to the iPad unnecessary. The same thing I find touchscreen on the Mac, useless gimmick. But that's my point of view. What do you think? Please answer below. That's it. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the thumbs up, and turn on notifications. Make sure you check the links in the description. Beside offers and discounts, you may find some Apple products and accessories there as well. Thank you so much for watching Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye. CyberGhost VPN. Surf fast. Stream anything. Face no limits. Hide your IP and stay secured. Up to 83% of discount with extra 3 months for free. CyberGhost VPN.